Okay, it's very late. 52, 50, I mean, sorry. Chav Zayin, who got the Torah Achre Eis Gimel. Okay, so he says that, what is the union of learning Torah, separating the hair, and then you become from white wool to become to white hair, which is a much higher level, and you connect yourself to Hashem. So he says, Sheyaskov, he is bein in Adam and Afshim, when a person meditates in his nefesh. Echshay Deisul, Salalocha Shalat Torah. By combing out, meaning clarifying, that's what it means in a simple sense. Clarifying the halacha that you should know what's allowed, what's not allowed. The Sveimim Nafshi is Neshama becomes elevated, Lalis, in Tal Baruchu. And he becomes elevated to Hashem, Memele Yogov Yisrael Chet Ves Hashem. Then he'll be able to rejoice. The fact that he's becoming connected to Hashem, so then he'll realize he can rejoice with Hashem. Which is earns a baruch u'makar achayim makar tainugim, then he'll realize that he can connect to Hashem and he'll have more enjoyment. Yesim yidav kol, like it says, tachas shel avados Hashem lekecho b'simcha tuv levav yidav kol. What it mean? Afilu mechayel ma'bar ganeidin tachtim ve'elyin. He says a person when they do mitzvahs can rejoice more with Hashem than even ganeidin ha'elyin, even the lower level and even the higher level of ganeidin. Why? Because that's only ziv. It's only a ray of the Shechina, Gan Eden. Here, you're connecting to the essence of Hashem, like you said before. V'gam b'china is a ziv. Even about the ziv, it says, al-achir, motiv de ladayna. In other words, like this. Even the ray is so great that the Gemara says it's worth for achir to go to the punishment of Gehenim that he should go to the world to come. That means even though it's only a ray of the Shekhinah, it's also very, very great. How much more so when you don't connect to the ray, you connect to the essence? When a person will realize his whole hope and his whole desire in learning Torah is lesanik al Hashem mamish, to have enjoyment with the essence of Hashem, which is the source of life, the source of pleasures. And he says, we don't feel it now. He says, we don't see it now openly. In Gan Eden, at least they feel it. Here we don't even feel it. He says, why don't we feel it? Not because of a low level. It's too great for the worlds to handle. In other words, it's a pleasure which is higher than world, so we in world can handle it. Therefore, we can't even understand it. So he says, if that's the case, you shouldn't even have more simcha, because we understand, we don't feel it, but we understand that the pleasure I'm getting from connecting to Hashem by doing a mitzvah, which is greater than the lower Gan Eden, higher than the higher Gan Eden, that he's getting such a level of godliness, in other words, he says the simcha is even greater. Not only are you getting Gan Eden, lower level, higher level, which only raise, yeah, it's great. Like it says, Achish should go to Gehenna in order to come to Gan Eden, but here we're getting even greater. You're getting a revelation and enjoyment with Hashem, a connection with Hashem that is so great that worlds can't handle it. And therefore, we don't feel it. The same thing, we're learning Torah, not only doing mitzvahs, but learning Torah. It says, which is like white snow. Thought and speech of a person, and b'chinas levushim, our garments, like it says in Tanya, machshava levush apnimi, and dibur is levush emtzoi, the middle, can the garment. You know, it says like this. It's later. Right? When a person thinks, it's the internal garment. Therefore, why is it called levush emyuchel legrilim? Because it's so connected to the nefesh. The nefesh always functions. So does thought. Dibur is separated from the person, but not as bad as action. So he says, when you do mitzvahs, you're basically doing action. When you learn Torah and do other speech mitzvahs, then you're connecting your thought and speech, which is much deeper even than action.